gave birth to Christ, who gives life to the world. To grant protection from harm and strife, and to keep his anger and his wrath far away from us. May he lead us on the path of life and glory. As we honor you this day, we sing his praises. Alleluia, we ask for your prayers.
Exalt your Blessed Mother Mary on the Feast of her Assumption. Through her prayers, make us worthy to rejoice with her at your right hand. And we meet you in glory, and we will raise glory and thanks to you, to your Father, and to your Holy Spirit forever.
Amen.
Peace be with the Church and her children.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace and good hope to all.
Holy Trinity, we burn this incense. Kyrie eleison. Let us raise glory, honor, and praise to the Son of Justice, who in his grace dawned from Mary, who is the great East, and in his divine rays gave light to the whole world. To the hidden child, honored the day by his mother's Assumption, and exalted the blessed memory, her blessed memory, on earth and in heaven. To the good holy glory and honor on this feast and all the days of our lives and forever.
Amen.
O Christ, the Word of God, and the Son of the Eternal Father, at the appointed time you chose to take flesh and to be born of the Virgin Mary, the daughter of David, and you fulfilled your plan of salvation for us. You lifted up your mother to be with you and crowned her as the Queen of Heaven and Earth. Today we honor the feast of her glorious Assumption, and with the holy apostles who gathered from around the world to honor her, and with those who serve you in heaven, we cry out to her with noble melodies, proclaiming, "Come in peace, O pure Mother. You gave birth to God the Word and carried the heavenly King in your womb. Come in peace, O temple of the Holy Spirit. You are the dwelling place of God the Most High. Come in peace, O spiritual ladder seen by Jacob. Through you we climb to the heights above the power of suffering and death. Now, O Christ our God, we ask you, through her prayers and with the fragrance of this incense, to grant forgiveness of sins, security to churches, and peace to monasteries and convents. Help the elderly, encourage the youth, nurture the children, and grant rest to the faithful who have gone to you. Make us worthy to be united with your mother, Holy Virgin Mary, and the choirs of the prophets, apostles, martyrs, and confessors in your eternal kingdom, where we will raise glory and thanks to you, to your Father, and to your Holy Spirit forever.
Amen.
O Mary, Mother of the Lord,
David's daughter, full of grace,
this is world of sins, for the joy of your parents, in the host of the cherubim and seraphim, for God's son, and the law of the church, and the earth will rule.
that we have offered on the feast of the Assumption of your Mother, the Blessed Virgin Mary. With the holy apostles, make us worthy to honor the day of her departure from this world, and grant forgiveness to your flock that celebrates her feast. We raise glory and thanks to you, to your Father, and to your Holy Spirit, forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
From the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Luke, who proclaim life to the world. Let us listen to the proclamation of life and salvation for our souls. And Mary said, My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he has looked upon his handmaid's lowliness, and behold, from henceforth all nations and ages shall call me blessed. The Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is from age to age upon those who fear him. He has shown might with his arm, dispersed the arrogant of mind and heart. He has thrown down rulers from their thrones, and has lifted up the lowly. The hungry he has filled with good things, the rich he has sent away empty. He has helped Israel his servant, remembering his mercy, according to his promise to our fathers, to Abraham, and to his descendants forever. This is the truth. Peace be with you.
Praise and blessings to Jesus Christ, our Lord and God, for giving us these words of life.
My soul doth magnify the Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. On this glorious day of the Assumption, of course, what we are celebrating is twofold. On one hand, we honor a single individual woman for the things that God has accomplished within her. On the other hand, we have a much more universal vision of a restoration of the human race as God intended it to exist. When mankind was first made, Adam and Eve were created, and created in the friendship with God in his grace. Death was not meant to be part of this. And so it is thought by the theologians and by the fathers that one would arrive at the end of the days that God's providence would have foreseen for us to spend here below, in paradise, with our family, our children. And at that moment, we would be then transformed, transfigured, and brought into the vision of the eternal light of the Hidden One. And so today, we celebrate in this woman, Mary of Nazareth, the restoration of the origins of the human race, in which the individual was meant to be created in the friendship of God. So Our Lady was born and conceived, born without sin, or Immaculate Conception, which we will honor again in December. And this untainted and unstained creation of this woman was because of the Son that she was going to bring into this world. That the Eternal Son of the Hidden One was to enter into time through the womb of this woman. And therefore, as the new Eve, if you see the kind of flip side of the way creation and the recreation was done, so that as in paradise Eve, woman is the first to fall, but it is the fault of Adam who falls in time, subsequent to her, by whom we are all wounded. It's by Adam, not by Eve. And so when we see in time, God recreates woman through the Blessed Virgin Mary, and through her is born the new Adam, who brings the redemption and the new creation to the world. So it all centers around this conception that she has of the Messiah. And that's why the Church has chosen the Magnificat today, this canticle, which is recited in St. Luke in the first chapters, which is her song of thanksgiving as she comes to her cousin Elizabeth's house in the Visitation. We'll talk more about that in the Supore, the season of announcements before Christmas. But it is her canticle of recognition that everything which is happening to her, the child that she carries in her womb, the fact that this child is jumping and moving around in the womb of her cousin Elizabeth, recognizing the presence of the Messiah even before his birth. This woman in her song of thanksgiving recognizes that everything is done to her because God is powerful, and that God is good, not because of anything that she has done, but could possibly merit before their creation. And so she recognizes that all honor is paid to God, and that is her lowliness, her littleness, her smallness before God that she says that the Lord has looked upon. So we honor this day a woman who is transformed from her birth of a new creation, of the new human race that is meant to be by grace in the kingdom of God and the sacred mysteries. But we also honor God's work of that new creation, because the transformation that takes place, and of course if you look at the bulletins that I put out this week, I gave you the translation we have in the Syriac, that we refer to this as being the repose, or the quiescence, the rest at the end of her days of the Blessed Virgin Mary, and her departure taken by the seraphim and the cherubim into the kingdom of light and the kingdom of God. And so that transformation is also a reminder to us that this is our destiny as the children of God, that we too are meant to enter into the vision, body and soul, on the last day for us. We have to wait. But what happens to the Blessed Virgin Mary is obviously different in degree and plenitude. But the fact that the promise that all of us are meant to be glorified in soul, in body, in our immaterial and material existence, in that kingdom of light that we call paradise, that is what anchors our faith and anchors our hope of this day of glory. And so we honor the Blessed Virgin Mary for both of these things, her own person and for what she represents to the human race. May her prayers be with us, the ever-glorious Virgin Mary, and may her prayers always be to us a rampart and a strength. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. We believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible.
We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate in the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified and crucified. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will not end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and we look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life for the world to come. Amen. Oh, reigns clothed in majesty. Alleluia. Our Lord Jesus said, I am the bread of life. From the Father I was sent, as word without flesh, to give you life. Of the Virgin Mary I was born, taking flesh as man. As good earth receives the seed, her womb received me. Priestly hands now lift me high above the altars. Alleluia, our gifts, Lord, receive.
Almighty Lord and God, you accepted the offerings of our ancestors. Now accept these offerings that your children have brought to you out of their love for you and for your holy name. Shower your spiritual blessings upon them, and in place of their earthly gifts, grant them life and your kingdom.
Amen.
As we remember our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ and his plan of salvation for us, we recall upon this offering all those who have pleased God from Adam to this day, especially Mary, the Blessed Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, Saint Mary, Saint Jude, and Saint Charbel. Remember, O God, the children of the Holy Church, our fathers and mothers, and our brothers and sisters, both the living and the departed, especially those for whom this sacrifice is offered, for the repose of Bishop Shaheen. Remember also all those who share with us today in this offering. Amen. O Lord, on high and from all creation, you are peace, reconciliation. reconciling those who are offended. You are forgiveness to those who sin. You are comfort to those who are sorrowful. Open the door of your mercy to our petitions, and in the abundance of your grace, accept our prayers. Make us children and heirs of your kingdom, through the grace of your only Son and his love for all people. Through your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
O Lord, you are adored by all. Angels bless you, humanity exalts you, and all creation glorifies you. Look upon your children who call out to you. With purity and holiness, may we offer you an acceptable sacrifice. We may raise glory to your only Son, and to your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Of God the Father, and the grace of the only begotten Son, and the communion and indwelling of the Holy Spirit, be with you, my brothers and sisters, forever.
And with your Spirit,
let us lift up our hearts, our minds, and our hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord with reverence and worship Him with humility.
It is right and just.
Truly it is right and just to thank the Lord, glorify and bless the majesty of the one consubstantial Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Our majesty that does not need our glory, or become greater with our thanks. O Lord, those who sing your praises are confidence, and they cry out with angelic voices and sweet melodies proclaiming,
Holy, 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 mighty Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your great glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who has come and will come in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
Glory to you, O God, the Heavenly Father, for you have exalted our weak human nature. In your mercy you sent your only Son into the world for our salvation. He dawned from the Holy Virgin like a ray of light from a bright cloud. He took the form of a slave, yet truly he is the Son of your majesty. He willingly became man to make us divine. He was born from a woman's womb, that we may be born again from a spiritual womb. He became our brother, so that through his grace we may become your children and heirs. He took us from being slaves and made us your children. He promised us a share of the reward that allows us to call you Father, Father. He cleansed us from our sins with his precious blood that he poured out for us. For he is your only Son, Kyrie eleison. Anam hadakum harsha dinema dekhaye. En sada dachma dina parishato. O Arethu Kodesh. Masoya. Dio ti chiedo,
Amen.
We offer
We all pray for the pure bishops of the true faith, Francis, the Pope of Rome, Bishop Peter, our Patriarch of Antioch, Nisrala Peter, our retired Patriarch, Gregory John, our Bishop, the venerable priests, the chaste deacons, the pure sub-deacons, and all the orders of the Church. Teach them the word of truth, so that they may spread it faithfully, with justice and holiness. May they get care for the flock which you have entrusted to them. Give them the proper means to accomplish your will, and grant them a long life. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the poor and the dejected, for orphans and widows, for the sick and the distressed, and for those tempted by evil spirits, be the guardian and refuge of their lives. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember the holy fathers, the prophets, the apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, and confessors, especially the holy, glorious, and blessed ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of God, St. John the Baptist, the messenger and forerunner, who witnessed the betrothal of your holy Church to your Son, glorious St. Stephen, the Archdeacon and first martyr, and all who pleased you and professed your name, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember also, O Lord, to shed your light and mercy upon the soul of our beloved Father, Bishop Shaheen. Grant him life and consolation in your luminous paradise. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all the faithful departed who have gone to you from this altar and from every place throughout the world, grant them rest in your heavenly dwellings with all your saints, and in your mercy forgive our sins and theirs.
Grant us to God, and forgive us sins which have been committed. May you
O Lord, do not deprive us of your mercy, but keep us in the palm of your hand, lest we fall and go astray. So that we may walk on your path, follow your ways, and do your will. Forgive us and our departed, and pardon all sins and transgressions, hidden and seen, committed with or without your knowledge. Make us worthy of a faithful Christian death that is pleasing to you, and join us to your righteous ones and to those who have done your will. That in us, in all things, your blessed name may be glorified in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, and of your living Holy Spirit, now and forever.
As it was in the beginning,
yourself for us. You are the forgiving sacrifice who offered yourself to your Father. You are the high priest who offered yourself as the Lamb. Through your mercy, may our prayer rise like incense, which we offer to your Father through you. To you be glory forever.
O Lord, our Lord, you sent us your Son, who is the radiance of your eternity. And he accomplished his plan of salvation for us, that we might return to you. May we call upon you with the prayer that he taught his holy disciples, saying, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Yes, O merciful Lord, we ask for your compassion. By your grace, make us worthy, that your glorious name be made holy in us, that your kingdom come to assist us in our weakness, and that your will dwell within us. Deliver us from all difficult temptations. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, with your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
O Lord God, you are good and the lover of all people. Look upon those who bow their heads before your majesty, and bless them with every spiritual blessing. Do not turn us away when we approach your divine holy gifts, and let us not be guilty but unworthily of receiving the body and the blood of your only Son. Rather, make us worthy to share in your holy and life-giving mysteries with purity. We may raise glory and thanks to you, to your only Son, and to your good and Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
The grace of the Most Holy Trinity, eternal and consubstantial, be with you, my brothers and sisters, forever.
And with your spirit.
Holy gifts of the Holy, with perfection, purity, and sanctity.
One Holy Father, one Holy Son, one Holy Spirit, blessed be the name of the Lord, for he is one in heaven and on earth. To him be glory forever. Make us worthy, O Lord God, so that our bodies may be sanctified by your holy body, and our souls purified by your forgiving blood. May our communion be for the forgiveness of our sins and for new life. O Lord our God, to you be glory forever. The host of angels have come to stand with us at the holy altar. They sing in chorus and carry Christ the Lamb, sacrificed before us. O come receive him, the saving Lamb of God, who will grant forgiveness. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
grace, Lord, to forgive us your body to eat and your living blood to drink, O Lord, of all people, have mercy on us.
Have mercy on us, O Lord, O compassionate and merciful one, O lover of all people, have mercy on us.
Lord Jesus, you have made us worthy to share in your holy body and in the cup of salvation. How can we repay you for these your gifts and graces and for your goodness? As you have called us to approach this life-giving banquet, make us worthy, so that your body may be mingled with our bodies and your blood with our souls for the pardon of faults, the forgiveness of sins, and for eternal life. You are blessed and your kingdom is holy, and we raise glory to you, to your Father, and to your Holy Spirit, now and forever. Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
O God the Father, we bow before you, and we entrust ourselves to your care. We worship you, imploring your mercy to rest your right hand, full of blessings upon us. Assist us, protect us, bless us and sanctify us by the cross of your Holy Son. We glorify and honor you, your only Son, and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Go in peace, my beloved brothers and sisters, with the nourishment and blessings you have received from the forgiving altar of the Lord. May the blessing of the Most Holy Trinity accompany you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the one God.